So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247. Main hu Manish Mishra and guys, in today's session we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B and NABARD. So let's begin with the session, but before we begin, if you are coming here for the first time, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon. And also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily sessions, and you can also ask any doubts here, or iska link you will find in the description. All right, so let's begin with the very first question, which is a very very important question guys. Isme se question aapke exam mein 100% aane wala hai. It is about intensified mission Indradhanush 3.0. intensified mission Indradhanush 3.0 abhi recently launch kar diya hai. It has been recently launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare. So the question says you have to identify the correct statements regarding the intensified mission Indradhanush 3.0. So before moving ahead to the intensified mission Indradhanush 3.0, let's talk about the mission Indradhanush. So if you remember, humne pehle bhi discuss kiya tha, mission Indradhanush was launched by the government of India, was launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare in the year 2014. Ye kab launch hua tha? In the year 2014, with an objective to ensure full immunization to the children up to 2 years of age, and the pregnant woman. All right, so full immunization ensure करना था बच्चों का जो कि 2 साल तक के हैं, and the pregnant woman. And under this program, 12 vaccinations are being provided to the children up to 2 years of age and the pregnant woman. And after its success, intensified mission Indradhanush. Intensified mission Indradhanush was launched in the year 2017. Remember this also. Intensified mission Indradhanush was launched in the year 2017, and after its success, जो ये intensified mission Indradhanush था, इसकी success के बाद intensified mission Indradhanush 2.0 was launched. And under this second edition of intensified mission Indradhanush, the focus was on those districts जिनके पास immunization coverage 70% या उससे कम है. The focus was on those districts which had the immunization coverage 70% or below. All right. So this is about the mission Indradhanush, and now the intensified mission Indradhanush third edition has been launched. Third edition, 3.0 edition has been launched by the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare, and this third edition focuses on the children and pregnant women who have missed their vaccine doses during the pandemic. जिनकी वैक्सीन डोजेस पैंडेमिक के दौरान मिस हो गई थी, उनको उनके ऊपर ये फोकस करता है. एंड रिमेंबर, इट विल बी कंडक्टेड इन टू राउंड्स. ऑलराइट, देयर विल बी टू राउंड्स स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम 22 फरवरी एंड 22 मार्च. 22 फरवरी और 22 मार्च से 2 राउंड स्टार्ट होंगे, एंड ईच राउंड विल बी ऑफ 15 डेज. 15 दिन का एक राउंड होगा, और उस 15 दिन में उन चिल्ड्रन और उन प्रेग्नेंट वुमेन को कवर किया जाएगा हु हैव मिस्ड देयर वैक्सीनेशन डोजेस ड्यूरिंग द कोविड-19 पैंडेमिक. एंड रिमेंबर, the districts have been classified into three categories. Number one is low risk, then medium risk, and high risk. And in the low risk category, there are 313 districts, while in the medium it is 152, while for the high risk it is 250. And remember, this program focuses on the high risk 250 districts. 250 districts ke upar ye focus karega jo ki high risk mein hai, and these 250 districts are across the 29 states or the UTs in our country. All right, so guys, you can expect a question from this news. This is very important. And now let's come back to the question. I hope you can easily answer this question. Now the mission will be conducted in 3 rounds. No, the mission will not be conducted in 3 rounds. It will be conducted in 2 rounds, starting from 22nd February and 22nd March, and each round will be of 15 days. All right, and the mission will be conducted in 250 high risk districts. Yes, the mission classified the districts into 3 categories: low risk, medium risk, and high risk. And this mission will focus on 250 high risk districts across 29 states and UTs. The mission classified the district as low risk, medium risk, and high risk. This is also correct, and we have to identify the correct statements, which means option B, only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 2. So Union Minister of Road Transport and Highways, and who is that? He is Mr. Nitin Gadkari. Nitin Gadkari is the Union Minister of Road Transport and Highways. His Lok Sabha constituency is Nagpur, which is this also known as City of Oranges. And remember, he is also the Minister for MSMEs. So this ministry has launched Go Electric campaign to spread awareness on the benefits of e-mobility. Which of the following agencies has been selected as the nodal agency for the implementation of the campaign? So remember, this Go Electric campaign has been launched by the Union Minister of Road Transport and Highway with an objective to spread awareness on the benefits of e-mobility and electric vehicle charging infrastructure. All right, electric vehicle charging infrastructure, electric cooking और इलेक्ट्रिक मोबिलिटी को के लिए अवेयरनेस स्प्रेड करने के लिए दिस कैंपेन हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड एंड रिमेंबर ब्यूरो ऑफ एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी हैज बीन सिलेक्टेड एज द नोडल एजेंसी टू इंप्लीमेंट दिस कैंपेन. ऑलराइट, सो इसमें हमें इतना ही पढ़ना है. एंड रिमेंबर द ब्यूरो ऑफ एनर्जी एफिशिएंसी हैज बीन सिलेक्टेड एज द नोडल एजेंसी. दिस कैन बी आस्क्ड इन योर एग्जाम एंड द नेम ऑफ द कैंपेन कैन ऑल्सो बी आस्क्ड इन योर एग्जाम. राइट, सो डू रिमेंबर बोथ थिंग्स, द नेम ऑफ द कैंपेन, हु हैज लॉन्च्ड इट, and which agency has been selected as the nodal agency. All right, so therefore the correct answer, guys, to this question is what is the question? Which of the following agencies has been selected? So it's Bureau of Energy Efficiency. Remember this, option B here is the correct answer. And now let's move ahead to question number 3, which is about an MOU that has been signed by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation with an organization in India. So with which organization in India Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation has signed an MOU for promotion of health research in India? Health research ke sector mein, health ke sector mein research ko promote karne ke liye this MOU has been signed by Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation with CSIR. So this is very important, do remember this. CSIR ke saath Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation ne ye MOU sign kiya hai taki health ke sector mein research ko promote kiya ja sake, so that the health research can be promoted. And remember, the area of research includes genetic diseases that impact the infant and neonatal mortality rate, new diagnostic and devices for infectious disease, development of cost-effective processes for drug, vaccine, biologics, etc., novel microbiome-directed foods, and socio-economic impact of science and technological tools. ये सारी चीजें याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है. These are just for the basic understanding. Just remember, an MOU has been signed between Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation and CSIR for health research in India, for promotion of health research in India. All right. So therefore, the correct answer is what? CSIR. CSIR is the correct answer. And who is the Director General of CSIR? It's Dr. Shekhar Mande. And Prime Minister is the ex-officio President of CSIR. And Union Minister of Health and Family Welfare is the ex-officio Vice President of CSIR. All right. So here the correct answer is what? Option E, CSIR. And now let's talk about the question number 4. Consider the following statements regarding Tree Cities of the World program. Tree Cities of the World program, it is an initiative of FAO. FAO ka ye initiative hai. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding Tree Cities of the World program. Now it was in news because Hyderabad has been declared as the 2020 Tree City of the World. Tree City of the World Hyderabad ko declare kiya gaya hai for the year 2020. And remember, it is not only Hyderabad that has been declared. There are various cities across the world that have been declared as the 2020 Tree City of the World. Bahut sari cities hai jinko declare kiya gaya, but remember, from India it is only Hyderabad. And also remember, it is the only city in India to get this recognition so far. Abhi tak India mein ye akela city hai jisko is tarike ka recognition mila hai. And this Tree City program is a joint initiative of Arbor Day Foundation and FAO. Arbor Day Foundation, it is basically an NGO type of thing, and FAO, Food and Agricultural Organization, we all know, it is headquartered in Rome. And Rome, of course, is in Italy. And who is the Director General of FAO? It's Mr. Qiu Dongyu. Qiu Dongyu is the Director General of FAO, and it was established in the year 1945 with the motto, "Let there be bread." Let there be bread is the motto of FAO. And since it was established in 1945, so last year in the year 2020, it has completed 75 years of operation. And on that occasion, Government of India has launched a commemorative coin of rupees 75. Okay. And this recognition, guys, has been given to Hyderabad for its two programs. One is Harita Haram program and another is the Urban Forest Park program. Harita Haram in English means garland of greenery. Garland of greenery. Harita Haram is a Telugu word. It is a program of government of Telangana, and in English it means garland of greenery. Okay. So talking about this initiative, so as I told you, it is a joint initiative of Arbor Day Foundation and FAO, and it recognizes those cities and towns which are committed to ensure that their urban forest and trees are properly maintained. Aise cities or aise towns ko recognize kiya jata hai जो कि इस बात का ध्यान रखते हैं कि उनके जो अर्बन फॉरेस्ट है और जो उनके अर्बन ट्रीज हैं या नॉर्मल जो ट्रीज हैं वो मेंटेन्ड हैं. ओके, एंड देयर आर फाइव क्राइटेरिया ऑफ इवैल्यूएशन. नंबर वन इज द एस्टैब्लिशिंग द रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी, सेट द रूल्स, नो वॉट यू हैव, एलोकेट द रिसोर्सेज एंड सेलिब्रेट द अचीवमेंट. सो दीज आर द फाइव क्राइटेरिया अंडर विच द ट्री सिटीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड आर इवैल्यूएटेड अंडर दिस प्रोग्राम, ट्री सिटीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड प्रोग्राम. And talking about Harita Haram program, so as I told you, it is a flagship program of Telangana government to what? To increase the green cover of the state from 25.16% to 33%. 25.16 से लेके 33% तक लेके जाना इसका objective है. And under the urban forest park program, forest blocks in and around the cities are developed as the urban forest park. All right. So for these two initiatives, Hyderabad has been recognized as the 2020 tree city of the world. Okay. So now let's come back to the question. You have to identify the correct statement regarding this program. This program is a joint initiative of Arbor Day Foundation and United Nations Environment Program. So is that United Nations Environment Program? No, that's FAO. FAO, which means this statement is incorrect. There are 10 standards for the evaluation cities. No, there are 5 standards for the evaluation cities. 10 nahi hai, 5 hai. And Bangalore is the only city in the country to be recognized as the tree city. No, that's not Bangalore. It's Hyderabad. It's Hyderabad. Hyderabad is the only city in India to be recognized as the tree city, which means all the statements are incorrect here and we have to identify the correct statement. Therefore, option D, none is correct, is the correct answer. And if you remember, recently DRDO inaugurated India's first hypersonic wind tunnel testing facility in Hyderabad. Wind tunnel testing facility. It was India's first. Remember this, and it was inaugurated by Defense Minister Rajnath Singh. Okay. So here the correct answer is option D. None is correct. And guys, that's it for the session. I hope all the four questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Milte hain kal ke session mein. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.